All right, welcome into the Thanksgiving edition of Hot Reads with Hall of Fame quarterback Troy Aikman. I'm Tom Vandervoort. Let's talk about Thanksgiving, Troy. Seems to me you're always working on Thanksgiving. You played in a number of these Thanksgiving Day games, and I just got to ask you, what's it like to play on Thanksgiving Day?
Well, it's good. I mean, I enjoyed it. It took a little bit of getting used to, but I think the fact that, you know, the Cowboys and the Lions play on Thanksgiving each year, it gives those teams a real advantage. Not only do they play on Thanksgiving, but they play at home on Thanksgiving. We always felt that it gave us an advantage. It almost served as a second bye week coming off of the Thanksgiving game. So, you know, we would play on Sunday and then, of course, play Thursday at home. And we got used to that schedule as to what it took. You know, we'd come right in on Monday, start getting ready for whoever we were going to face. Then on Thanksgiving, I always felt it was a disadvantage for the teams that we were playing because, one, obviously a short week, which both teams had to deal with, but they weren't accustomed to doing it every year. And then the fact that they had to travel, so there was one less day for our opponent to be able to prepare because of the travel. Now what we see with the NFL Network game and the Thursday night games that we're seeing that started up already this year, more and more teams are getting used to the fact of playing on a Thursday, which helps them for those teams that are playing on Thanksgiving Day this year.
Do you have any favorite memories, any favorite games that you played in on Thanksgiving?
You know, there was a couple games that were good for me. The best offensive day that I had, the highest yards passing that I had, was actually on a Thanksgiving game against the Minnesota Vikings. So there were some real clunkers too. And, you know, my first year to play against the Philadelphia Eagles was not one that I'd like to remember. And then, of course, the Miami game in 93. It was the only time in my career that I played in snow. And it happened on Thanksgiving in Dallas, Texas. And that was the game that we lost when Leon Lett had a miscue down the field. But it's a great tradition. You know, there's a lot of people at home. It's part of their Thanksgiving. And I'm thankful to have been a part of it for so many years.
I did want to ask you about that Leon Lett game because that one obviously stands out. So what was the mood in the locker room like after that? Do people understand, do teammates understand, hey, you make a mistake sometimes? Or another one like, Leon, what the hell, dude?
Yeah, it was, you know, I never have played a snap of special teams. So I was standing on the sidelines with Michael Irvin when the ball was being kicked. And when it was blocked, you know, I just assumed, as everyone did, that we had just won the game. And then the next thing I knew, they were lining back up to kick the game-winning field goal again, and they made it, of course, and we lost. And I was in the locker room for a good 30 minutes, and I kept asking, what happened? You know, why did we lose this game? And, you know, that came on the heels of Leon Lett, you know, having the miscue in the Super Bowl the year before against the Buffalo Bills. And you know, Jimmy Johnson was our head coach at that time, and I remember waking up on Friday morning, and I fully expected to see that Leon Lett had been released from our team because that was kind of the way that Jimmy Johnson did things back then. Instead, I woke up, and the headline said that Leon Lett would not be cut from the team, and I knew then that this guy, even though he was playing very little on our defense, that he must be a special player because if Jimmy didn't think he was really talented, he wouldn't have been back on the team, and as years would show later, he was a heck of a defensive player for us.
You know, it's funny, I was watching some highlights of this, and there was a little girl apparently who sent a postcard to Leon Lett saying, don't worry about it, Leon, everyone makes mistakes. You should have seen the bonehead play some guy pulled in the Super Bowl the other year when he was running in for a touchdown, celebrating too early.
Yeah, both those bonehead plays were Leon's.
All right, man. Well, listen, enjoy another day of work on Thanksgiving. Appreciate your time, and we'll catch up with you next week.
You bet. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody.